Cheers.
Thank you, ladies. Cheers.
A virtual toast for virtual celebration. Honoring 100 years of service, the Torrance Women's Club still going strong, even in times of COVID. Their contributions recognized by city leaders, past and present.
The Torrance Women's Club basically mirrors our city. Although we were founded in 1912, it was created in 1921 when our city charter actually made us a true city.
We were founded by a group of ladies, sort of as a sewing circle.
The wives of the city's founders were among the group's charter members. Notable names include Isabel Henderson, the cousin of city founder Jared Sidney Torrance. Henderson had already established the city's first library in the parlor of her home on Gramercy Avenue.
Turned out they just grew exponentially, very quickly, building a clubhouse within a few years and paying it off within 20 years. So they were darn doers and achievers.
The Women's Club building has been along for the ride almost since the club's beginning. And if the walls of this 1925 building could speak, they would likely tell the tales of many good deeds done in the community.
We are very proud of our building, and we work very hard to keep it in that same style. You know, we've made a few upgrades, but we've tried to be very careful that they don't change the character of the building.
In the early days, everybody dressed. The hair was done. They, particularly in the 50s, you know, you had the matching outfit. The dress, the shoes, the handbag, the hat, the gloves.
As their membership grew, so did the scope of their service, expanding to shape many facets of Torrance history.
They've always they joined in when there was a need for something.
In 1940, the Pacific Electric Railway, known as the Red Car, was one of the primary means of transportation for city residents. It carried workers employed by the city's thriving oil industry in and out of town. In 1938, the PE Railway filed an application with the California Railway Commission to abandon its Torrance to San Pedro line. Torrance Women's Club members lobbied City Hall, demanding that this critical lifeline of transportation continue. Their vocal persistence led Torrance to establish its own municipal bus line on August 5, 1941, what came to be known today as Torrance Transit.
25 people from the Women's Club show up at City Council and say, we think this is a problem, or we want to support this. I think people pay attention.
The Torrance Women's Club still supports the cause. It collects gifts for children in need through the annual Torrance Transit Stuff-A-Bus holiday event. During World War II, the Spanish-style clubhouse became a hotspot for USO events.
We had a wooden dance floor, we had a stage, room for people. It was the nicest place in town.
Today, members include military veterans and also volunteers for the Bob Hope USO at LAX, such as Allison Jones. Jones' great-grandmother was president of the Torrance Women's Club in 1947.
It means a lot to me because my father and my uncles were in the military and people that I went to school with.
The Torrance Women's Club is unlike any of the other clubs I've ever belonged to in that it doesn't really have its own agenda. It's constantly evolving along with what the community needs, what they can do to help, the different skills that people bring into the club. There's an opportunity to do anything you want in this club, from coming and having lunch and going home and doing nothing, to sewing things, to being on the fashion show committee, to being on the fundraising committee, and we try to encourage people to do what they're comfortable doing, and we also try to kind of encourage them to step out and do a little more than they're comfortable doing.
Betty Herbst was one such member who joined in 2001. She was initially just seeking some ladies to play cards with.
In the meantime, I discovered that they had a Helping Hands group, and no one was chairman. So I volunteered to do that.
True to its sewing circle roots, the Helping Hands sew huggy bears and cuddle quilts for young emergency room patients at Torrance Memorial Medical Center and Providence Little Company of Mary. They sell their wares at the club's annual holiday bazaar and Torrance Senior Craft Fair to raise money for one of the club's primary interests, providing scholarships to further the education of local students.
Usually in a pre-COVID year, we spend about $10,000 on scholarships. Because of our philanthropy and our commitment to volunteer work, that's part of the things that we look for on the application. How involved are they in their community?
Katie Kennedy is a registered nurse at Torrance Memorial who benefits from the group's scholarship efforts. Funding helped this mother of two finish up her nursing degree at LA Harbor College.
Was just thankful to have that, I guess, acknowledgement from a group of women, and especially in the community that I grew up in, women that have been doing so much great things here, and to receive it as a woman and a mother, it was really special.
Currently, more than 130 members volunteer their time for the group's variety of philanthropic projects. This includes its annual holiday fashion show fundraiser. The clubhouse serves as the host for the annual Torrance Historical Society's Historical Homes Tour. The dynamic of the group has shifted a bit during the COVID-19 pandemic. They're now meeting on Zoom. Its oldest member, 100-year-old Lois Jones, looks forward to getting back to her role of managing the club's donation-based library and seeing the friends she credits with keeping her young.
I actually like taking care of my books. But I love being involved with the people that are in the club.
We've called each other, you know, and just hearing a person's voice saying, how are you doing today? Or even the emails, I think that's a way of staying connected. Very nice that people, we reach out to each other.
We started out with the homemakers. We transitioned into more business people. We've transitioned into the retired teachers, nurses, librarians. Now we're getting the techie people. But I don't think the bottom line changes that much. It's still, what can we do to help? Where are we needed? How can we support each other? How can we raise money to help somebody else?
It's a century of service that's no doubt made Torrance a better place. In Old Torrance, Colleen Farrell.